Avengers wasn't that great. I'm fucking sleepy. It brings to my attention that people tend to get fanatic about superhero movies, and you know, I don't blame them. It's just, who wouldn't want to be a superhero flying around and just doing willy-nilly? Not a lot of stuff to say about it. Just generic superhero movie crossover. And then they had this thing about the women superheroes, and I didn't really care. A lot of people had beef with that. I missed it. It was like, whew, gone. So apparently Captain USA gave it to a black USA, so that's a thing. Iron Machine just ran out of oil, so that's that. So no more Iron Machine series from there. And oh yeah, the fucking Widow bitch. She dropped. She dropped like a fly. And no one really cared. It was funny. What else can I say about the movie? Time travel.
You what?
None of it makes sense. None of the shit makes fucking sense. Like, this blue chick, Nebula, she tries to sync up to go back in time, but then she has like a fucking internet spasm or lag spasm or something like that. She lagged out or something. I don't know. Yeah, and then she just got fucked by Thanos. He's like, I died. Oh, fuck. And then, here, I'll show you. This is Thanos, as everyone knows. This is Thanos. And he's like,
so, future me succeeded my plan. Okay. So, I guess I'll just look at all of the Avengers and go back in time. And then I'm just gonna kill everyone.
And then, that's it. To sum it up, this guy is the only thing that I liked. I cried 3 times just because he showed up, he farted, and he just like, hey, I'm Spider-Man. It was like, oh my god, my heart. That's it. That's basically the movie. 3 hours of fucking talking about, man, wish I went back in time. That's basically it. I wish I could go back in time. And there you go. 4 out of 5. Let there be light.
Oh shit, there's light.
Lightning.
What do you even?
Bring forth thy hammer. He's taking his time. Any minute now. It's coming. Hammer? there's my hammer.
My hand appeared in the middle.
There it is. Why'd you throw it?
Whoops.
I lost my grip there. Alright, welcome to my first episode of Jake the Judge, where I, yours truly, judge everything that you enjoy. Whether it be video games or movies, I'm here to tell you why you're stupid. So today, I'm here to judge. Yep. That one. Avengers Endgame is something I've always had a gripe on. Not because of how popular it is, mostly, but because of how the film devolves into this time plot hole, which a lot of movies tend to suffer from. But the difference is, it's fucking Marvel, baby! No one can deny the amount of buildup it took to gain such a mass following. Hell, it's so big that it's engraved into our own pop culture. We're still talking about it to this day. Well, what did you expect from a team that were planning this for 10 years? What the fuck? But I'm not here to praise them about their work. Not in the slightest. No. I'm here to judge the film with my opinions.
Oh, he needs some milk!
But before we do that, let's take a trip down in memory lane and let's go back where it all started.
September 10th, 1963 was the main foundation of spreading and colliding different heroes against and with each other, creating what we all know today as the Avengers. Labeled as Earth's Mightiest Superheroes, the comic had, well, you guessed it, superheroes who would form the Avengers to stop big evil threats from attacking the world. The comic was published by Marvel Comics and was co-written and produced by the late and greats Stan Lee and Jack Kirby. Although I can go on about Stan Lee and Jack Kirby's greatness throughout the whole entertainment business, or their immense creativity of making heroes relatable and believable, I don't want to linger too long on the obvious. That being said, let's respectfully pay respects on these amazing people for what they brought to the world and creating our childhood heroes. Even if it was purchased by Disney. Alright, so we saw where it came from. Now, let's see where it goes. Outside of comics, it undoubtedly grew out in other forms of media, from animated TV shows, to toy brand and merchandise, and even sick, epic clothing lines. But there seems to be one thing I haven't mentioned yet, but I can't quite put my finger on it. Anyways, 2008 was... 2008 was very significant for Marvel fans as a whole. No. Avengers 2012 is the one I'm going to present with you mostly, considering that it's relative to Endgame. So the Avengers is the film that started it all. As a character and world-building point of view, let me finish! And it sparked the possibility and potential of what a superhero group could be in films. So much possibilities, so many stories, so much money!
Hello, I like money.
Overall, it's a film that introduces a lot of chemistry with other heroes that later on will be more apparent in the future installments. Speaking of those, let me just tell you what happens real quick. So, Iron Guy makes a smarty robot that's too smart, it wants to kill mankind. But then Yellow Smart Robot Guy stops and kills the other robot and blasts him like a Dragon Ball Z episode. Half of the universe dies, as well as Spider-Man. Alright, now it's time to talk about Endgame.
Yo, what's up, dude? Wait, who the hell are you? I'm you, stupid. Don't you even look at a mirror? Oh wait, I know you. You don't. You see my new hairstyle? Cut my hair and everything right here. Got the mustache. Oh, I see you did the same thing too. What happened to my hair? Anyways, did you get to the ugly part? That ugly part. You're gonna get a lot of people riling. Tell you what.
Wait, so you're future me?
Yeah, I'm you in the future.
Why are you here?
Oh, I'm just checking. You know, I'm just checking what you've been doing. Yeah, okay. Can myself look at myself at the time?
That doesn't make any sense. If you were cutting your hair in the future, how is that going to affect me in the past? Wouldn't I have to cut my hair to change your future?
Mm-hmm.
But if there's different dimensions and different timelines, how is that going to affect you if we're different branches? You interacting with me, will that change the fact that we're not going to be part of the sequence? Wait, hold up. My brain is melting.
Alright, well,
Keep up the good work. All right? You're going to need it. Oh, and by the way, stay off Twitter.
Why? What happens on Twitter?
Just don't use Twitter.
Fuck.
So let's touch on the movie on three categories. The good, the bad, and the ugly opinion I have about this film. Let's start with the good part. For a 3-hour movie, it was really well paced. I mean, going into the tragedy and outcome of Thanos' snap, to having silly montages of failed time travel stunts, it honestly keeps people invested into the story. Most characters that were there throughout the movie have valuable roles, key plots that fit into the narrative perfectly. Some characters caught my eye, but none has made me feel more at home than frickin' Thor. You know, I never really cared about Thor until this movie. As a pure, handsome deity that was created by the almighty Odin, in the end, he turned out to be something else instead. To me, Thor in Endgame is the embodiment of being human. Because not only does he mess up so badly, he single-handedly lost everything and everyone, namely his entire family and most importantly, himself. Having feelings of self-doubt or being unworthy is something that a lot of people have gone through. Making mistakes and regretting them for the rest of their lives is something we live through on a day-to-day basis. That's what makes us human. Giving Thor this characteristic is what makes him so relatable. We see him throughout the film as this repugnant waste of a man who has nothing to live for because he has absolutely no one to live for. Burdening the mistakes he made that caused half of the universe to be wiped out, later on regretting and hating himself as he rots his mind and his body for 5 years, only hearing a faint voice in the back of his head repeating those same words he heard so long ago. You should have aimed for the head. Now that's a good character. Seeing him surprised with relief painted in his eyes that he could wield Mjolnir gave me goosebumps. He endured so much pain, but in the end, he came into terms with his own mistakes, and he learned from them. Accepting limitations and understanding is what makes Thor human. And Thor is a literal god for crying out loud. Also, I like his gamer moments.
What the fucking bro? Come dance, maybe cast for energy. I'll come out of my house, and I'll break your fucking legs, you little prick!
Thank you, Thor.
Captain Marvel sucks. Honestly, I can rant about a lot of things in this movie. For example, Steve Rogers just stole like another Captain America's life and somehow went back into his own timeline, meaning the exact place and the exact time they sent him to the past. Like, what? Or the fact that both Hawkeye and Black Widow were surprised that, you know, they need to know the sacrifice for the Soul Stone. Like, it's common sense, you know? I mean, they mentioned this in the movie. Also, the fact that, you know, Captain Marvel was built up to this pinnacle plot point, stopping Thanos, but turns out she's just there for, like, 2 scenes. She's basically a shameful waste of a so-called actress. But I do like her hair. But there's one thing I want to talk about, and that is the frickin' rat. Out of all the possibilities that Doctor Strange foresaw, and a rat was one of them. I don't understand why they felt the need to give a full-fledged reason for a rat to accidentally press that button. Think about it. If it wasn't for that rat, none of this would have happened. Which is cool to think about, but it just doesn't really fit with the whole getting that one chance of stopping Thanos. Destined to redo history and saving everyone. A rat randomly pressing a button just by luck? To me, doesn't fit that. It just makes it less meaningful and a lot less believable. I know it sounds like I'm nitpicking here, but if a narrative is pulling me into this journey of redemption and changing history, well, at least give me a valid reason on how it started. Give me a good reason on how Scott Lang got out of the quantum realm. That's all I want. Or at least acknowledge the frickin' rat saved the entire world. I don't hear anybody thanking the rat. Hello? That rat should have been in that funeral ceremony. Just saying. I don't like the fact that people watch this film multiple times. There, I said it. I mean, what makes you go out of your way just to rewatch the film 6 times in a row? That's like 18 hours wasted over a movie. Look, I had my fair share of watching movies multiple times, but doing a 3-hour movie on a whole day is absurd. I shit you not, there was a 1:50 a.m. showing on Thursday, and it ended at 5. Yes, 5 in the frickin' morning. And there were already tickets sold for that showing. 150 people to be exact. I honestly wouldn't watch Endgame for the second time. I just don't see the point of seeing the first act again, because that's not really the good parts you're gonna watch it for. Don't get me wrong, it's not boring the first time you watch it, but watching it the second time may drag a little longer than you think. Let's just agree that the film is pretty great. Although it had some questionable flaws, overall, it did deliver on a bombastic conclusion to the Avengers saga. And that's a winner in my book. This has been your very own Jake the Judge, judging this film of Fat Thor at a Dying Black Widow's. Aww, yeah. And I'll see you guys next time on Jake the Judge. Peace.